session which we are going to start, or the workshop which we have arranged, is on the blockchain. So I'm very sure that you must have heard about this particular blockchain word before. Okay, so basically, to start with this, what we are going to cover, this today's workshop is to show you what are the things that we are going to cover in our course. I think every terminology which we are going to cover throughout our online session. In our online session, what is a table of contents? That is, what are the things that we are going to cover, that we are going to discuss? A little bit of a introduction about what is blockchain is that we are going to start with. So let's go to this. So I'm just starting with the one presentation first. Okay, so that presentation will give you idea that what we are going to do with in this particular course. See, as this blockchain area is a sea of concepts. Why I am saying it is a sea of concepts? Because there are many terms that we can just discuss about the blockchain. You must have heard about cryptocurrency. You must have heard about like the cryptocurrency like Bitcoin, must have heard about Ethereum, Ethers. There are many trading sites and all. So you must have heard about the word Hyperledger. So many terms are there. But out of which this course is going to deal with the Ethereum dApp. So we are going to learn how to create our Ethereum decentralized application based on Ethereum platform. So what exactly? Is it the only thing that we are going to understand in this course? Absolutely no. Because we are going to understand, first of all, from where that blockchain word came from. It is evolution for that particular blockchain from the Bitcoin to Ethereum to Hyperledger or any other future technology is we are going to discuss in this course. That is going to be our first module. Okay. The second module in the course that we are going to see is between this evolution and the Ethereum. We are going to also understand what are the blockchain ecosystem, how it works basically, totally from start to creating your address to what do you mean by transaction, what do you mean by different types of blockchains we have. Then take the name of every concept, that is key concepts we know as key concepts that we call it as. Okay, so every that term that we are going to understand in the first phase and before we start with the second phase. So this is our second module. So in the second module, we are going to understand if the Bitcoin blockchain was there, what was the need to come up with the Ethereum blockchain? And what is the advantage over that Bitcoin blockchain to the Ethereum blockchain that we are going to have? Second thing, how it works. So as we have understood the blockchain ecosystem, we will definitely understand how Ethereum blockchain also works. Okay. So the next thing is, as we understand, now these two phases are not too small. So it is going to take a lot of time for us to just cover these two points, as what it includes, I'll tell you soon. I'll just explain that thing in the TOC. Okay, just wait for it. The third module is we are going to create our own private blockchain based on Ethereum. Okay, so there are many professionals like you may have a question that why not we are creating our own blockchain and why we are using the Ethereum blockchain for that moment. But this course scope is that we are going to create a private blockchain with the Git client on the Ethereum platform. So as if you ask me, ma'am, can you just go tell us the way that can we create our own blockchain? I have a links that I can share it with you. That probably a one more one class discussion that I can have it with you. But the whole hands-on will be on this. Okay, there are a number of ways that we can discuss about the creating our own private blockchain. But this is the one of the way where the which is popular among all the developers, which is popular among a lot of people, that we are going to have it in the course. Okay. Then the next module, what we are going to have it as is understand and learn Solidity. Basically, Solidity is a language to write. So once we understand what is Ethereum, Okay, in Ethereum, we are going to have a small piece of code which run on blockchain. So how to write that small piece of code, which language that we are going to use it for that particular purpose. So that language is known as Solidity. Okay, so as you may ask question, ma'am, Solidity is a high level language. Yes, it's high level language. It's just like your Java. Now, mostly the professionals or the people who are attending this particular workshop, they understand when I take this word Java. I think it's very, very popular language among all. So how did Java we write, how we class, we like usually write in the similar kind of way that the Solidity is going to help us to write the smart contract. Now, what is smart contract? I just in the this workshop session, I'm going to go through every concept. I'm just going to give you a demo of each and everything. So I'm going to give you a demo of the Solidity also today. So the language which we are going to learn from the scratch, and now here, considering the time period and going through the Solidity course, so we are going to start from the scratch, but we are going to learn this particular Solidity in terms of use cases, like Solidity smart contract on healthcare application, Solidity smart contract on Ethereum game applications. Like that, we are going to understand this particular language. So which is the tool that we are going to have it here for the compilation purpose is the Remix is the tool that we are going to see it in the fourth module. Okay. The next module is developing a front end, because as the course says that we are going to develop a dApp. So at the end of this course, what you're going to have is dApp that you're going to create at the end. Plus you will have all the information and knowledge about the blockchain and the various tools that we are going to use it on the Ethereum client. Same, which is the front end tool that we are going to use it here is we are going to use Truffle and Web3. Okay, so these are the tool, and plus is MetaMask. What is that MetaMask, Web3, Truffle? That we are going to understand. Plus I'll tell you what, when we create a front end, we are using Webpack. Why we are using Webpack, how it is possible to implement that, all stuff that we are going to discuss in the this module, that is our fifth module. Okay, and lastly is our dApp implementation. So if we combine these two, that is our Solidity, our Geth, that is it possible for us to implement a dApp and deploy that on our local net Geth? Yes, it is possible. So we are going to see these four things we are going to combine, and the final phase is going to be creating your own applications. So while going through this particular phases, these are your outcomes is what I'm talking. Okay. So while going through this, I'm not going to leave each and not a single concept that we are going to leave in between. So this is what the scope is, what we are defining for this particular course. And then afterwards, these are the modules which I told you, but after the completion of dApp implementation, we are going to have various use cases for this. Probably I'll ask a lot of students from you to just participate in hackathon. I'll just give you a way or help you out with the implementation of new terms that I'll be able to. Together we can do it at the end of this. But the course scope is this. And at the end of everything, that is the after dApp implementation, we probably discuss a future scope. That is Hyperledger or maybe Hashgraph. So I'm going to explain about it, the way of working of each of them. But hands-on will not be included in this course. It could be the future course that we'll be implementing. As I'll just show you the thing here. As we have discussed, there are many modules we have. So you must have understood that it prerequisite is at least you should know a programming language, because it's not that you should know depth in that depth. We should know that each and every that Java also, but at least if you
what
know
programming Java, language,
any programming language like logic understanding. So if you know Java or JavaScript, okay, so little bit of it, then you will be able to understand a Solidity language. There is no
front end languages like HTML5 or CSS3.
हाँ ओके सो एज हियर द फ्रंट एंड लैंग्वेजेस वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इट इज HTML वी आर डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू यूज JavaScript इज देयर CSS इज देयर बट एज द डी एप इम्प्लीमेंटेशन हाउ मच इज रिक्वायर्ड दैट मच ओनली वी इट इज कवर्ड इन द कोर्स इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू कवर द होल HTML इंट्रोडक्शन फ्रॉम स्क्रैच वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू कवर दैट Okay, because at the course limits to our DApp implementation on the blockchain, it is the scope is limited to this. So whenever it is required and that part is required, that much I'm definitely going to explain in the course, but it is not going to be from scratch.
Myself, Shiva.
Hi, Shiva.
Hi. Madam, actually, can you tell me briefly what is the feature of this course?
Yes, the feature of this course is that As I already told in the course content, I'll just open this course content. Okay. Can you see this, Shiva? The modules are, yes, the modules are introduction to the blockchain, in which we are going to cover about what is blockchain history, what is distributed ledger ecosystem, how the centralized ledger and the distributed ledger are the different, what are the different types of blockchains, is there any difference between the public and permission blockchains, then what is the blockchain across the industry, what they are expecting from the blockchain, that we are going to talk here in the first module. Second module is we are going to talk about all the key concepts like what is mining, node, what is peer, what is block, what is Merkle tree, what is blockchain, what are the consensus mechanism we have, proof of work, proof of stake, Bitcoin, how Bitcoin works and what is exactly transaction. This is going to be the first introduction part only. So here it is, we are going to talk about every concept that blockchain includes. Then the third module will come is like, what is Ethereum? How the Ethereum blockchain is working? Why it is known as Ethereum blockchain with smart contract? What do you mean by smart contract? How the Ether, number of cryptocurrencies we know, and what is the difference between the Bitcoin and the Ethereum blockchain? What is Ethereum wallet? Can we have money in that wallet? What is testnet? What is actual network? What is Ethereum client, Geth? So we're going to talk about every Ethereum concept in this third module. What is the fourth module is Solidity. Here Solidity is one language, as the many of you may have a doubt that what is Solidity is just like a Java. I just want to give, shall I just shift to that page or is it okay, Shiva? You are getting what I'm saying?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, okay. So I just shift to here that everybody is getting. Yes.
If nobody don't know about of Java, then we can cover the Solidity course.
See, it will be a little different. Yeah, yeah. Just that's what I'm saying. Solidity will start it from scratch. Okay. So Solidity, there is no problem. I'll let you know. But the if you know any programming language, it will be a better hand or a greater thing in this course, because if you know that, it will be easy for you to just grasp everything, because there are many concepts included in the course.
Suppose, madam, I am coming from .NET platform. Then this course is can benefit to me on future?
Yes, definitely. As the .NET is why we use .NET or any kind of language to solve any problem, right? So yeah. Blockchain is also one kind of technology, or blockchain is one kind of area from which the people are expecting more and more from this particular technology. As you can go through news and the many contents that you can see it online also. But the blockchain is kind of technology from which the many kind of solutions can be solved. So out of
just
which
give me an example, which type of that we can utilize this type of a product. Can you give me brief example on which
sure,
type of?
Sure. Just let me rephrase things. Like for example, the security purpose. Okay, the many of the applications which we implement nowadays. Okay, whether you take it the .NET technology also. So it's going to be a centralized database. Am I right?
Yes.
What does it mean by centralized data? That means whatever we take it from our front end will go to back end and it will be saved at one particular location, right? Now, this particular blockchain technology is a distributed technology where the centralized database is completely removed and it is going to be known as distributed databases. Okay, and this particular solution is in terms of security, increasing security, because here whatever transactions we do, okay, we cannot, no one can touch that particular transaction. When I'm saying this, I have a proof here in the course. Okay, no one can touch, in the sense blockchain is, what is the word blockchain? It is blocks chain. Okay, that means the blocks are connected in chain, and these blocks nobody can edit. Once it is uploaded on the blockchain, it is uploaded. Okay, so that way it is secure. The data is safe. Even though it is visible, it is safe. Okay, there are many more technologies, like it is not centralized, it is decentralized. Okay, and the transaction cost, like for example, if we are taking banking applications, for example, okay, banking applications will take bank as a middleman and takes the transactions to the centralized database. Okay. Then what happens is that centralized data can be manipulative. Okay, sometimes we can think that the centralized database can be manipulative, whereas this kind of databases will not be manipulative. Second thing is, whatever the transaction cost that bank is charging for you to transfer the money from one account to the other account, the transaction cost here is very minimal. Transaction cost will be there, but it will be minimal. I think as of now, you will not be able to understand the various examples I am taking, but the advantage here is secure. Advantage here is less transaction cost. Advantage here is it is distributed or decentralized. Anything
Excuse
else?
Excuse me?
Yeah, sure. Solidity.
Is it compulsory to learn Solidity or which?
Actually, the platform which we are working on, may I know your name?
Yeah, ma'am, my name is Vipun.
Vipunai. So what I was telling you is that, your question was that we are working on the platform Ethereum, right? So Ethereum is a technology or the blockchain with the smart contracts. What is the beauty of this particular blockchain is that we can write a small piece of code which is written in the Solidity language, and that can be deployed on that blocks of chain. Okay,
My question was, can we have the substitutes for the Solidity?
Yes, we have a substitute. We have three languages actually that the smart contract can be written: the Solidity, Serpent, or LLL. But out of which, Solidity is very popular among all the developers, which we have observed throughout very conferences and every group of people. Then we concluded that this is the best course that we can develop.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, and as Balaji suggested, that we will have the query solving session at the end of the course or end of the session. Is it okay with everyone?
Yeah, sure.
We'll go ahead with this understanding of. So I was talking about the Solidity. So I just wanted to show you how that Solidity look like. And when you are learning new things and you're learning blockchain, which is the latest technology, then it is definitely going to be useful for you.
But what are the prerequisites, madam, actually, for this? I joined, that's why I'm asking.
Okay. So what are the requirements that first you should know, understand? At least as you are already in the IT field, so there won't be a problem understanding the network. There won't be understanding problem with the understanding with the database. Then there will not be understanding of the language which we are going to use. So I think there are three requisites that you should be able to understand this environment better. Prerequisite. I think... And if nobody knows about it, I just want to clear it, that if nobody knows about anything out of this, then I'll try to cover that part, but it is not going to be depth or scratch. So that way we have to understand. You can join the course. I'll definitely brief you about it, but it is not going to be a 10-15 classes based on that. Okay, as everyone, I was talking about the what is Solidity language, how it look like. So which is the Remix tool? Just now in the PPT, which we have seen that Remix is the tool that we are going to learn here for the Solidity language. So here is the tool. This is online version. Okay, in the next session, probably, I think we are going to start our online classes from 15th of Feb. So from 6:30 to 7:30 in the morning, okay, So from that, actually, I'll be able to show you some installed tools from that. But here, as of now, I'll be able to show you an online tool, which is Remix. Okay. So here, can you see a code written, something like functions I have written? I'll just go through this, but not completely. I just wanted to show you something. Just wait. Okay. Now, can you see a contract word written here? So as if you can see the contract word written here is just like a class in Java language. Okay. The class in the sense, this, what is this contract? It is the structure which I'm going to write here. Okay. This contract is one kind of coin flipper. I am going to call, I'm going to deploy on the blockchain. So this is going to give me a dummy blockchain here. The environment shows that I have a dummy blockchain with the JavaScript virtual machine. I will be able to connect it to real blockchain also. I will be able to connect to my private blockchain also, that I will be able to do this through this tool. This tool is for the compilation purpose, as we are not going to start Solidity today. So definitely I just want to show the code look like that. I have a class written that name is as contract. This is the name of the contract. Some variables are declared here. I'm able to write a method. The method is written with the syntax function. Okay. I'm able to just call these particular methods anywhere in this particular contract. Okay. Now, what does it mean by deploying this particular contract? Okay. So I just want to show you a demo. What I'm going to do with this particular contract. You know what this particular application is? This is an Ethereum game. You know what is this game is all about? That any kind of person, like player, can participate into this particular application. I'll just bigger the screen. Great. Okay. Now, as I am going to deploy this particular smart contract on the chain, so how will I able to do? So just carefully see what I'm saying. No need to understand anything here, because as is expected, you should if you don't know this, it's better for us. Okay. So what I'm doing is I have 100 ethers. It's my balance. I have a cryptocurrency in my account. It's just like a wallet for me. Okay, this particular address is holding 100 ethers. So I am handling this particular address. So I have 100 ethers in my account. Okay, I am just transferring this 50 ethers to this particular contract. Okay, I have written this particular coin flipper as a contract. Okay, so what I'm trying to do is I'm going to deploy. So how I'm going to deploy this particular contract? As of now, you just simply understand I'm trying to put this code on the chain. Okay, so I'll just click on create, will help me to put this chain on the, or put this code on the chain. So it got deployed. Can you see some blue or orange shades methods over here? These are the methods I have written in my code. Okay, as they have mentioned public, I will be able to see it outside the contract. Okay, so visibility also I will be able to write it here. Okay, that's why I will able to see all of the methods written here. Now, as what is the contract balance already I transferred? Can you check the balance is decreased by 50 ethers and actually more than 50? So, you know, I have transferred 50 ethers, but it charged me a transaction cost some 0.1. So that's why it is showing 49.9 ethers I left with. Okay, so now what I will do, I'll just change the address. In another address, I have 100 ethers. This is a participant into this game. Okay, what is this game is all about? I just do, you know, have you heard of Flip a Coin? It's a betting application. So what I'm going to do is from this particular account, I'm going to transfer some 10 ethers and I'm going to say bet. In the sense, I say that 10 ethers I'm betting on, and if this head comes or tail comes, then whatever I'm betting for, if I win, I should get double of this. And if I lose, then the 10 ethers will go to this contract only. Okay, you understood the betting game? So what we are doing here is I'm going to bet and flip. So this is method that any player can interact with. Okay, as of now, it is for understanding purpose. We haven't developed any front end for any kind of users. Okay, so I just want to show you, if I click on bet and flip, So can you see here something written over here? It is showing me that the transaction is successful. Okay, so that what do you mean by transaction successful? What do you mean by transaction not successful? You'll come to know throughout the course. Okay, so now can you check that once I click on bet and flip, okay, it got successful. And can you check my balance here? It increased by 10 ethers. You know why? Because I win that. See here. So how much I bet for 10 ethers? What is the double of that? So if I reduce 10 ethers from that, it was some 89. Okay. So now I got 20 ethers back from this particular contract because I win. So now I'll just go to another account. Okay. I'll just bet another 10 ethers from this account. Okay. And try and just click on it. Okay. But again, I win. Okay. This is my good luck now today. Okay. So you may have a doubt, ma'am, whether you have written a code for only win purpose. No. We have written it properly for win and lose. Okay. So I'll just check with here if my luck goes bad. It is good for us. No, it's always a win. But there are cases that we can lose it also. Okay. So I'll just do it one more time. Is it interesting to know things are going on here? I'm again winning. Okay, so I'm luck. My luck is on head. Okay, what I did is that we have methods. I'm interacting with these methods. This is a remix tool which is helping me to interact with these methods. This is a test net. That means some default accounts I am going to have. Some 5 default accounts and 5 default ethers. 100 ethers in each account I have. Okay, but in real time or your private blockchains, you may not have this much balance because each one ether is $1,000. So understand the cost we are dealing with right now. So here what we are saying is that by default, this is for the playing purpose. That means you can just play with it and understand how it is going to be on the real blockchain. So you may have a question.
Sachin, yeah, yes? 2 questions I have.
Sure.
So very first question is that I think we have written 2 methods here, which is one for winning the game and one for losing the game, right?
No.
Okay. So then how at runtime it decides that it should be a win or it should be a loss?
Because there is a math calculation. We did it in the program. Okay.
Oh, so that's a user-defined function, right?
Yes. It's a user-defined function. Everything is user-defined here.
Okay. Now the question here is like how on runtime it is deciding that it should be a win or a loss.
No, it's not runtime. I wrote this code and I developed this application. Are you getting this?
Okay. When a user wins or loss, this a gap of 0.01 Ethereum. Okay. So who owns that money basically at runtime when, let's say, for example, if I'm actually buying Ethereum coins online, okay, and when I see there's a gap of 0.01 Ethereum, so who basically owes this money?
The transaction cost, you are saying?
Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly.
The transaction cost, that means 0.1 it is charged for me for the transaction will go to network. Okay. So we'll go to network in the sense. Now you have to understand the theory behind it, as it is charging me some money to do this transaction, but where this money will go? Okay. As I told you that this is showing me the transaction is successful. Okay. As this transaction is successful, that means in the network, the other nodes are present in that should verify that. And that is known as mining. Okay, and the transaction cost it charged me will go to miner. Okay,
that answers my question. Thank you.
Okay, so what is evolution of blockchain? How it came into picture? Have you heard of peer-to-peer network somewhere? You can answer at least one of you.
Yes, we
did. Have you heard? Okay, so what is
yes,
this?
Yes, no, I did.
Okay, good. So can you see the diagram in front of you? It is World Wide Web, right? So that means any kind of request and response kind of applications we are working on, that is client server applications are working on. We work on such kind of network. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay, so now let's take the another example, which is peer to peer. Okay, as a lot of you said that you heard of this particular technology already, that is peer to peer network, right? So now peer to peer network, there is a basic difference between this particular diagram. Can you see what is the basic difference between this particular two diagrams? Can anyone tell me?
One is centralized and another one is the decentralized.
Right. You're absolutely right.
But okay. both are distributed, one is centralized, another one is decentralized. Both are distributed, right?
No, they're not distributed. Distributed means the data is copied on, it is replicated among all the computers. And centralized means the data is stored at one location and these are the clients. They act as a client, they request to the server, server will respond to it. Okay.
Got it.
And now peer-to-peer networks are that everyone from this particular network can act as a client, can act as a server. So that means anyone can request for the service and anyone who is able to give that service will respond to it. Okay. Are you getting this?
Okay. Yeah.
So now the peer-to-peer network, okay, this is the peer-to-peer network. So what is the advantage here is we are removing this centralized concept. Now what happened here, it is not wrong. See, the technology which both of the areas are not wrong, but which kind of application want to run on which kind of network is our wish or requirement. Okay, so the centralized databases or centralized network, what is the problem? If these things get collapsed, okay, the whole data can be lost. Okay, that is a disadvantage, is the disadvantage that we can talk about. But you may have solutions for this because this world is going really ahead. So you may have a question, can we have replicas of this on the other servers? Yes, we do have. But what is a charge or what is a cost of maintaining the centralized servers is very high. Plus, we cannot deny a chance that it can be still manipulative. It can be still altered by the other entities. It is possible that data can be changed. In that manner, this kind of networks are more, now I will not say that it is more trustable right now because we haven't added blockchain into it. But these kind of networks will have many replicas. So you may have a question, ma'am, then there is no problem of the database. So here we are going to solve that into that thing also into the blockchain. Because the Merkle root, you must have heard about this, or if you don't, then we have to learn that into course. Do not worry about it. So we are going to maintain a Merkle tree, which is going to short that data into the header. And that's why it is going to take very less memory to replicas or do the replicas on this particular network. Now, which kind of network that we are the blockchain going to deal with? Peer to peer. You got that?
Yes, ma'am. Got it.
Okay. So now, have you heard of Napster or BitTorrent? I think many of us heard of. No? Okay.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Actually, these are the applications used for the file sharing purpose. I think the BitTorrent will be used for sharing movies or some kind of files to each other. Okay, these are very popular applications now. Like it started in 2001 and 1999. So they used this kind of peer-to-peer network. They're very popular enough. They're popular to share the files from peer to peer. So if I want any file from network, I should request. And then anyone who is having that kind of copy can give me that particular file. So for that purpose, this particular BitTorrent and their file type is different than the other file types we use. Okay. So that kind of applications we already implemented. Okay, but why I'm taking the name of this particular network? Because hello? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. So why I'm taking the name of this particular two applications? Because they started already using peer-to-peer network long back. And now the blockchain, okay, is going to use or is using this kind of network and it is getting really popular. So I'll just go ahead with that. Okay, so as we can understand here, kind of networks we do have. Okay, so this is a centralized network. This is a distributed. I think the many of us had that problem. That can you see the centralized will have only one copy, distributed will have many copies. And what is decentralized one? The scalable. So these distributed and decentralized could be the kind of a similar brother and sister kind of networks. But decentralized network can, it is going to be the more scalable, or infinite scalability will be added to this kind of networks. So now the blockchain will be working on these particular decentralized major networks. Okay. Okay. So what they work on the chronological order, I don't want to start this topic right now, but I am just going to give you a brief introduction about what kind of network that we are going to deal with. Okay. So I'll just go ahead. I'll just show you a blockchain diagram. Is it visible? So it is just to show you or give you idea that blockchain diagram, blockchain in the sense what, this is a one block, another block. Can you see them physically? Though they are virtually designed. Okay. But where they are stored at, they're stored at this particular physical computers. Okay. So now virtually when this particular blockchain gets implemented, okay. Okay, so what we just want to share it here is, as I told you on the coin flipper remix that just now we implemented, right? So I told you that transaction is successful, right? So transaction is successful, where it is going, that successful transaction, I did that, the every minor change into the blockchain is getting updated. Where it is going into block. The every data block is known as a list of transactions. Block is known as list of that particular or ledger of those transactions. So now each block will have such kind of transactions, and then each block is linked to its previous block. Now you can see that the block number 12 will have some transactions in it. Okay. It also holding a previous hash of block 11. That means what? Now what happens, I'll give you a scenario where I belong, the one particular piece of land belongs to me. Okay. Now it was, the case was in 2001. So I add that information on the blockchain in terms of block. So now the information is stored at block number 10. Saying that my land belongs to me, it is stored in the block number 10. Now what happens in block 2004, I give that land to one of my friends. So now that land is belong to one of my friend is loaded and saved that information in block number 11. As you can understand, they are also saving the time at what time that information got created, known as timestamp. Okay. Hello. Okay. So as we can say that the another friend come, okay, that land again goes to another friend in 2008. So now that land originally belongs to me, how will I understand or how will I trace? So with the, through this particular blockchain, I will be able to trace the history of that land. Okay. So now this blockchain is going to help me to trace back to the history. The blockchain is going to store the information. Okay. This blockchain is going to have the timestamp into it, hashes. So now the cryptography concepts that also we have to understand in this course. Okay. What does it mean by hash? Okay. How this hash is getting, how we are getting this particular hash. Everything is that we are going to understand in this particular course. Okay. Now, as you know, what that particular chain kind of stuff is blockchain. Okay, it at actually virtually, it's a data connected to each other. But where it is actually getting saved, they are getting saved on the physical computers. They're known as node. Okay, now, I just don't want to start it right now. So I'll just go back to this particular applications. Now, as I'll just go back to the different use cases and the applications, I must have told you that I gave that example of land belongs, right? So that is, yes.
Ma'am, by nodes, you mean the mainframe computers?
They're not exactly mainframe computers, as that concept will not come into picture. But as a node in the sense, each computer which is a participating into the blockchain will known as node. or they're connected to that particular node to network is known as node.
Madam, I have a question. Like big data, how you're using the hardware, like cheapable hardware, like we are using here all the same stuff like big data, Hadoop.
Yes, okay, yes. Hello, here I didn't get your question.
Big data where nodes are using like cheap commodities hardware we are using, right? Like that here also the soft hardware we are using like that cheap.
Yes, you are right on that. So big data, Hadoop is what the file systems we are using there to handle the big data, right?
And
So here is the whole concept changed with the distributed databases. So what we are doing, you know, each local node, its local database we are using for the saving data. So as we can see that the data, okay, throughout the network. So it is not using such kind of mechanism, but the whole blockchain which we are, it's going to be kind of a similar task. It is going to handle the data. It is going, now the concept here is as the blockchain will not hold the larger data, but we have a kind of technology known as intraplanetary file system, which we can link to and save our larger data.
Yeah, madam. Thank you.
Okay. So now I was talking about the example like Telangana government implementation blockchain. It came into Economic Times and you can just go through it. They already started using and saying that the land property kind of stuff they are going to implement into the blockchain. They already started it. So you can go through the links which is mentioned in the PPT. Throughout the course, I'll be sharing you whatever PPTs that we are going to discuss here, or maybe any kind of extra information that can be shared with you, links, documents, I'll be sharing with you throughout the course. So as here in the PPT, you can see that the voting, online voting, right? Many of us heard of e-voting also. Am I right? Have you heard of e-voting? What are the different types of voting you know? What are the different types of voting you know?
Yeah. Like particularly trading, we are doing voting, like business decisions will take.
So I was talking about the voting application in the sense, the traditional voting kind of stuff is what? Traditional voting is like we are physically going to the ballot and giving a paper and then submitting it to the ballot is traditional voting for the government purpose I'm talking. Okay. And then e-voting is like the applications can be built and the web applications can be built that so that the people don't have to go to the ballot, but they can sit at their place or maybe one particular location. Am I audible? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Okay, now, so if I go to a particular location, I don't have to go, but web application will give me a way to interact with the voting stuff. Now, what happens in the e-voting and the traditional voting we have? There is a problem of insecurity. There is a problem of it can be manipulative. So there is a thing that can be reduced in the blockchain, because as we know that it is a distributed applications, once the vote is uploaded on the chain, nobody have a right or it will not be able to change that. Now, what if I do something wrong on the chain? Then I have to add one more information to nullify that, but I cannot erase that information which is already uploaded on the chain. Okay, now what I'm saying is that in the USA, they implemented this particular voting or they conducted such kind of blockchain voting in the last voting scenario. Okay, it already implemented, but it's not largely accepted and they say that it is already hacked, but they're still working on it. And voting application is the very happening area where people are expecting more things to happen. Okay, so what people now, the current research people are asking is that ICICI Bank is already implemented for the intra-bank transactions, inter-bank transactions, not the intra-bank transactions, inter-bank transactions only at the Mumbai location. They did implemented that, and that to be again in the alpha version as whatever applications I'm talking are here. So actually you are right on that, and your question is very right, because why anyone will encourage Ethereum? But Ethereum is like Ethereum company who gave you that particular technology or the language. But like ICICI Bank, okay, they implemented their own kind of blockchain and their transaction. It is possible for those who want that private blockchains to be created to create your own blockchains. Okay, but startup, like I've just now shown you a startup like blockchain, Sofocal, or there are many startups or there are many companies who are working on the Ethereum smart contract. They're using that smart contract to implement more of the useful applications that they can do. Like, for example, implementation of Ethereum TV, Ethereum games. Okay, they can earn money out of it. So they are interested in implementation stuff. But as you said, there are many kind of companies will not be interested in using already existing blockchain. Okay, as it will increase their value more if you use that. But you are right on that. So they will go and implement their own kind of blockchain, or they just go for a Hyperledger, which is a private blockchain implementation. They can do it on that. But as of now, this kind of applications to be implemented, it's also not less. So we can count on this particular technology for better improvement.
Yep. I have one more additional question on that. This is Abhi.
Kabir, yeah. Tell
Abhi.
Me. Abhi. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
My next question will be, I'll write a smart contract using Solidity on Ethereum blockchain network. So let's say, can I reuse that same contract that I wrote on a different platform?
Yes. Because as it makes, sorry to interrupt you, but I got really excited to tell you about this answer. So is this thing is that it is really platform independent. As it makes it platform independent is because of the EVM we are going to use, is because Ethereum virtual machine, which help us to compile that program, and every kind of platform that we can invoke that. And once it is uploaded on the blockchain, anybody is able to invoke that.
Hello. This is Raj. Can I ask one thing? I have a quick question.
Yes, please go ahead.
Actually, I joined right now. That's the reason. Sorry to interrupting you. And actually, I have a Hadoop developer background.
Okay.
So is this blockchain related to, is any helpful to the Hadoop, or is it related to different
See, basically, as I will tell you, the concept here is blockchain is going to replace the whole kind of database concept only in the future. Okay. So what we are going to expect is that the blockchain can be integrated to many kind of technologies. For example, I take it IoT. Okay. So IoT can be merged with the blockchain. If you want to go through that, IBM is already implemented one kind of product for that. And they're open, they kept it open for people to try it. So you just also can go through it. So as the IoT is getting merged with the blockchain, definitely in the future that the big data or the data sciences can be combined with the blockchain, definitely, because blockchain is going to hold the larger data in future.
Okay, how is replaced to the Hadoop? So I didn't get you clearly. How is replaced to Hadoop?
It is not going to exactly going to merge with the Hadoop, but it is going to have the data sciences concept on in it. In the sense, I just gave you an example, like for example, you were there or not, I don't know, but this kind of stuff. So I'm saying that the data will be stored in the block, okay? And the chain is infinite, okay? So each block can hold, suppose 10,000 transactions or good data, okay, to hold it on. But so it's an infinite chain that I'll be building on. So as you can see, the Bitcoin blockchain live, okay? So I'll be able to show, I'll just try to show you here also, okay? But there the many kind of transactions stored. That means the data is getting stored in that particular chain. Also, the nodes are connected in the network. Node in the sense, one computer who is a part of that network, okay? So each node is also there locally. The local also, they save information on that particular node. So I'm seeing that it is a huge potential to save the data. If no, and then if it is go have to go to the larger data to save, IPFS is the file system. Okay. It's like that HDFS is, or the Hadoop file system is how it is like that. Okay. Such kind of file systems are also, we are going to have it here to store the larger data. I may not sound familiar what you want to ask, but I want to say that it can be good enough to handle the big data concepts in the future.
Okay, thank you. And the people who are looking for data science, is it very helpful for that with this blockchain?
helpful in the sense it's a parallel technology, and in future there are possibility to merge these two things. So there is a possibility, I'm saying.
Okay. Possibility means?
Possibility in the sense there are many researchers are going on to merge them. So we can see the good future in it. So you can definitely opt for this course.
So your intention is blockchain is support to the data science to build up ourselves.
No, the blockchain is, as I just told you, that blockchain have a potential, has a potential to change the whole complete database system only. So there could be the prediction, as what data scientists are supposed to do is to use that data, use the proper information out of that for the prediction in the future, right? So that also can be possible here in the blockchain.
Okay, thank you. Is it programming or it's different?
It's programming. So as I'll just show you here, our course module. So here as these things are theoretical. So I'm going to give you a explanation of how ecosystem, but the Git will be all hands-on in the sense here, you're going to have a lot of commands to implement your own blockchain. Okay. That I'll be able to show you here. There will be a lot of hands-on here. So programming is definitely here in the Solidity. And as we go in the front-end development, so you can understand the HTML code, even though you don't have to write, because Truffle is a framework for us, it will give you a first HTML, JS files and all, but there could be programming in all these phases.
Need to know any prerequisite for this?
Prerequisites are very simple, that you should at least have a minimal knowledge of the programming concepts. I spoke about some network, I just spoke about hash. Okay, so when I'm talking about it, at least you should have a little idea about it, not much and deeper.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Okay. Hello. Yes.
Ma'am, my question was, I'm Vipun.
Just can you put your mic just little far from you so that I'll be able to hear?
Ma'am, it's already far.
Okay, now tell. Yeah, it's able to hear now.
Is it his now?
Yes.
Is it still hazy?
No. It's I'm able to hear now. Just please continue.
Okay, ma'am. My question was: is blockchain really the future in terms of birth certificates, death certificates,
yes,
and marriage certificates? Because in India, as I've seen,
yes,
there are sometimes the spelling mistakes and age mistake. Mm. But if one block is already built and it's in the database. How we gonna undo that? It's already there.
Yes, you're right on that. But what is the thing that we can do is, as we have a timestamp, okay? Timestamp in the sense, in the past, my name was written some ABC, but I want to make it XYZ in the future, okay? I'm saying that in the future, I want to change it to XYZ, okay? Now I changed it to XYZ and put it on the blockchain. But which data you will find it correct? Which is the latest one? Are you getting this?
Yeah.
So as the timestamp will be connected to every data which we uploaded there. Okay. So the data validates at what time it got created, and which is the latest one will be considered fair enough or considered the true data.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, so you mean there are options to undo the things.
Not undo the things, but nullify things.
Okay, ma'am. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, Shimali. This is Nagesh.
Hi, Nagesh. Hi.
I have one question.
Yes.
For example, now the data, as it is loading in nodes wise, as it is in the blocks. So, like for example, in the US, say for ASN or any bank accounts, they are storing on the network. So that will be part of Indian computers, right? Indian system, which are part of the nodes, right?
Correct.
Or, for example, if in India, any one of the Aadhaar card can be stored in US computer node, right?
Yes.
You think India government or you American government will allow them to store it on blockchain?
Now, know your customer is, or proof of identity are the concepts here, what you're talking about. Okay. But now what happens is, as I belong to suppose particular one region, suppose India. Okay. And I don't want some documents to go and leak out of that particular stuff. Okay. So I will definitely go for a private blockchain for my country. I will not go for a public blockchain which are open for everyone. Okay, I have a facility to restrict that particular people who can be part of that particular network. I will be able to set that configuration. Actually, see here, the blockchain is first of all proposed it in terms of public blockchain. You are right on that. Okay, but as we have a different requirements for the industry, okay, we have a private consortium and permissionless blockchains also. So which kind of blockchain you're talking about is permissionless, that is Bitcoin blockchain. Okay. But as I need this kind of decentralized application to work for my private organizations or my country or any kind of organization which becomes a private, so they can implement their own blockchains for that matter. And it is also, we can see that in terms of Ethereum blockchain, we'll be able to show you that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I have two questions here. So yes. When you say data gets stored on the node, what's the underlying database for that?
So now as the Bitcoin blockchain, okay? So Bitcoin blockchain is a public blockchain. LevelDB on the local data, on local nodes, they use LevelDB database. Okay, which is NoSQL kind of database. You can connect it to it. NoSQL kind of database. They are not query languages. They are not query database. Okay, the language database they use it on the lower level is known as LevelDB.
What about the Ethereum?
Ethereum is also uses the LevelDB. Okay, and they have LevelDB is to store that kind of if they are full nodes. Okay, there are two types of concepts. The full nodes and light nodes. So light node may not have any local database to be attached to it, but the full nodes are who are having a complete blockchain stored on their particular node, they have LevelDB.
Okay, thanks. My second question is, if I have the smart contract written on Ethereum, can I deploy it on my Hyperledger?
Smart contract written it on Ethereum, and you want to deploy it on the Hyperledger.
Yeah. Yeah, so let's say the platform has been changed to Hyperledger and the company wants to use a Hyperledger. Can I deploy it on Hyperledger?
There may be a chance, but as the, we are using a different blockchain itself, so I think the you have to follow the some regulations for the Hyperledger. I think I'm not sure on this, but I will, what's your name?
Abhi,
I'm not sure on this, but yes, definitely it is going to be a different blockchain, so it will have its different rules and regulations for that. But I will get back to you once I just find out the way for doing it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Abhi.
Madam, only last question. What are the practical things like? Are we doing any practicals in this?
Yes. We are going to have a lot of good hands-on, huh? What are good hands-on in the sense? Many kind of hands-on on the Solidity. Okay, what are those hands-on on the Solidity? Are real use cases which actually there is actually, you know, eBay kind of stuff. What is eBay site will do? eBay, you know, eBay. Have you heard of it?
Yes,
e-commerce.
E-commerce site which the bidding happens, like the product can be given in that particular site and the people can see the bidding or bid for that particular product, and who wins that bid will get the product. Okay, that kind of applications already one kind of company is already doing, and we can actually such kind of real-time applications in our course. So we are going to deal with a lot of good real-time kind of contracts and real-time of applications here.